Okay, good evening all. So I think all of you got the note
good evening,
we have
sir.
Sent
yes,
via
sir. Yes, sir, got the note.
Okay, good. So because in the note that you have taken down, sometimes you miss these figures. That's why I have sent it again, right? Then you have the complete one with you. So if you miss anything, everything is there now. Right, the next thing is, in case if you miss or if you not receive, please let us know. Then we can check why we didn't send it or why we couldn't send it, because sometimes your name or address is not there in our database, maybe due to that. So please let us know, then we can check the issue. Okay, so last week we discussed about the issues, the physical and logical security issues that you face in the computer system. So one is how to protect your computer logically. The second thing is how to protect your computer physically, right? And so today what we are going to discuss, actually we need to write the summary. So what are the things that you can done to avoid these issues, right? Okay, so please write down the heading, avoiding hardware, issues. So please write the subheading, avoiding hardware issues. Okay, the first thing is how to avoid issues occur due to power failures or high power. Yes, what are the things that you can do in case of power failures or high power? What are the precautions?
Using a UPS.
Yes, you can use uninterrupted power supply. Uninterrupted.
Using a fuse.
Yes. So that is one solution. So that can anyway keep power on when it's suddenly off.
Using surge protection.
Yes, you can use fuse. Or you can use maybe breakers.
Using surge protection.
Yes, fuse or breakers in case of high power, it will turn the circuit off. So you can use surge protections, surge protectors. But in home, it's difficult because it's costly. So this is like a unit, especially when you need, especially if you have like these lightning issues. If more lightning issues, these days you have these lightning issues. So in case, sometimes it might damage your hard drive, hard disk or other components. So in case, if you are in a flats, if you are in a flat or some other taller building, then you won't get this issue much because they have these surge protectors. And they have surge protectors installed in the building itself. So you won't get that issue much. But if your house is in like, if it is in a top of a mountain or a plain, and the only place that you don't have much trees, but your house is there, then it's vulnerable. There can be more thundering affections or lightning affections. So therefore you can use surge protectors in that case. But normally if you are inside a large building, so this won't affect much. If you are using a UPS, that's enough. Fuse or breakers, that's normally they are in the power lines. No? Fuse tiyenone samane power line eke fuse thing. So if you take that what do you call this? So let me show one. Let me show one to you if I have. Nearby, I don't have any device, sorry. Let's search for. No, sorry, I don't have any for the moment. Otherwise, I could have shown. So this is something like fuse is something like fuse in multi plug. In multi plug and all, you have these fuses. It's inside the multi plug. In multi sockets, you have fuse. You can see the small one inside this multi socket. Here, this one, if you have.
Excuse me, sir, I have a fuse.
Ah, yes. Shamin, you can show it to us. But can others see? So those who cannot see, here this in the multi plug here, this one is fuse. So when this is burned, you can remove this. Make a burn uno to make a inkala dana pulu, angaluk fuse ekak dana pulu. So that will anyway protect your computer. So in power lines, you have fuse and breakers, of course, it's there in the it's there in your switchboard, ne? Breakers tiyenawani samanyen gedara ara trip switch ekak ekka ena switchboard eke breakers tiyenawa. අකුණු ගහන වෙලාවටම breakers වැටෙනවනේ automatically. So those breakers will fall down automatically yes. to protect your home appliances. So that is basically there. So if you are using like switches like the new KVL10 switches and all new one. So it has all these fuse and other protection systems with that. But anyone use a smart smart switches? Anyone use smart switches in home? How many of you are using smart switches? No one. All right.
What that means?
Yeah, smart switch means you can turn on the switch using your mobile phone. And smart switch.
No.
No. Google Home. Something like this, you can use a smart switch. It's a switch like this. You have these things now. Nowadays, you have these things in your market. This is smart switch. So replacing the traditional switch. It's a touch based one. I think in hotels and all, you have seen this sometimes.
Sir, in a school lab, there is one.
Oh, right, that's good.
Yes, sir.
Yes. I use few in my room because it's touch based and you can configure. You can connect using mobile phone and even it's responding to, some of these are responding to voice commands. Right? Voice commands. With Google Home, there's something called Google Home.
Sir, I have seen Google Home.
All right, this one, Google Home. You can connect these switches to Google Home and you can voice command to Google Home and program that actually. You can configure that and control that to automate your home, house environment. Get the environment to automate karana puluwa me wage ekakin Google Home. Right? So in future, maybe in near future, you'll be using that, right? So unfortunately, I had to move my laptop to show that the switch. Right. So, but I'm not in a position to move it now. That's why I'll show it. Right. I'll show it next day. And please remind me next day when I'm doing the lesson. I'll show it. Right. Not now. Okay. So anyway, let's move to the next one. Right. So power. If in case of power failure, you can use that high heat. How you can avoid high heat?
By installing cooling fans and air conditioners.
Cooling fans. And not only cooling fans. So what is happens? Okay, so next one is you can use air conditioners. Cool inside, you can use cooling fans or air conditioners. Air conditioners for two reasons. You can seal your room and make it dust
extra fans.
Yeah, you can use extra fans. That is again cooling fans, and you can use cooling
cleaning the fans.
Yes, cleaning the fans. ACs, and you can remove. Maybe you can use cooling pads and pads, and you can use cooling pad discs. Cooling, so this can be called as cooling discs. Cooling desk kiyala kiyana. You can use cooling desk also, not just cooling pads. You have used cooling discs. This is cooling desk. I think you have seen this recently in social media. Cooling desk. One show me in the single medium class. One show me that cooling desk in your home. Do you have that now? Anyone having this kind of item? This is cooling desk. It has fan installed in the desk. Here, this one. This one.
No, sir.
No, right. So this is like it's. Right, if you have, you can show it, right? Cooling desks. You can use it. Okay, so now you know that is also a way of minimizing heat. So how to minimize the insects and other animals like rats and cats and dogs?
Making the computer room clean.
Clean, yes, you have to make it clean and tidy. That's how you have to
dust free.
Use copper proof machines.
Yes, you can use insect proof mechanisms, basically insect proof mechanisms, right? Okay, so
I can't see you are typing.
I didn't type, sorry. I didn't okay. Type. Right, okay. Okay, so then high heat. Next one is insects. And third one, insects and other animals. So clean your room. So number one, clean your room.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes,
sir, we can't see.
Again, cannot see.
We can't see you.
Okay, so shall we rotate the sharing? Then you can select. Wait.
Okay, sir.
Can you see it now? Or still not?
You can't see the screen.
Cannot see the screen.
It's loading.
It's loading.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes it happens. I don't know. Recently,
this. Yes, sir.
Okay, let me rejoin, right? Let me rejoin quickly.